All right, so I'm going to kick off this review with an honest confession. 2 months ago, Bacard Audio reached out to me and they said, hey, would you be interested in checking out our S300 Mark IIs? So I went to the product page, I took a look, and to be honest with you all, I almost told them no. And I almost said no because when I checked out the product, I just rolled my eyes. I saw another MDF box with drivers stuffed inside. I mean, something that's been done 1,000 times. And on top of that, there was nothing in the literature that screamed, hey, I'm interesting, check me out. Still, the voice in the back of my head said, Sean, get over yourself, dude. Check it out, and who knows, you may even like them. And let's just say I'm glad I listened to that voice. And that leads me to my review of the Bacard Audio S300 Mark IIs.
Can one guy be? I kissed her and she kissed me. Like the fella once said, ain't that a kick in the head?
All right, so here it is, the S300 Mark II. Now, before I go over some of the speaker's details, let me first go over who Bacard Audio actually is, because I have a funny feeling not all of you are familiar with the name. So in short, Bacard Audio is a Danish company. They're actually pretty new to the scene. In fact, they just entered business in 2013, and right now, they have roughly 3 speakers in their entire lineup, which indicates how young of a company that they actually are. Now, as with a lot of hi-fi companies, their goal is to deliver the best value that they know how to offer. But to do this, they've done some pretty cool things. Number one, all of the drivers are sourced from a former engineer from ScanSpeak. And then on top of that, the person who actually designs their loudspeakers is a former engineer for Dyn Audio. That's a lot of pedigree to have under your belt. And on top of that, to keep prices low, what they've done is they've followed the consumer direct business model, which means you're not going to find these speakers at your local dealer. You're not going to find them distributed into your country. If you want to buy them, you buy them directly from the company. They ship it to your house. But the good news is you do have 30 days to determine whether or not you like them. And if you don't, Bacard will actually pay to have them shipped from your house to wherever they need to go, mitigating your financial risk. Now, onto the speakers themselves. As you can tell, they're pretty plain Jane. We're looking at a classic two-way loudspeaker. We have a soft dome tweeter here, a 1-inch soft dome tweeter. We have a 6-inch woofer. These are actually fairly substantial. I don't have the dimensions memorized. Just click on the description box below for that information. But I have a CD here to show you all just how big they actually are. Now, turning them around, you're going to see a rear port, a set of 5-way binding posts, and otherwise, just a very simple design that's not really about pretty so much as just offering great sound for the money. And in case I didn't mention it earlier, these retail for roughly 1,040 euro a pair, which translates right now into 1,200 US dollars a pair. So yeah, now let's talk about how they sound. All right, so let me try and make this as easy as possible. If you're somebody who likes a very lively presentation, something with tilted up treble, think Klipsch or B&W or Paradigm or Kef. If you're somebody who values big dynamic power and extremely agile bass, then you know what? There's actually a chance that you're going to enjoy other speakers outside of the S300 Mark IIs. But if you're somebody who says, hey, you know what? I have a big music collection. I'm looking for something that's fairly easy to work with. I'm looking for something that has treble that's not going to just destroy my ears on poor recordings, but something that's going to still be honest. I want mid-range that's fairly neutral, something that's neither too thin or too warm, and bass that actually sounds full. I want a pair of monitors that have some real balls to them. Then you know what? The S300 Mark IIs may be exactly what you're looking for. And when it comes to the sound of these speakers, think of it like this. When you listen to them, they're going to air slightly, and I mean slightly, towards the warm side of neutral. And this is informed mostly by their bass response. But I'll get to that in a bit. First, getting into the particulars, let's talk about the treble. Now, the treble's pretty interesting because I call it the jack of all trades. In other words, it has good air to it, but you're going to find other loudspeakers that are going to be a little airier. It's articulate, but you're going to find other loudspeakers that reveal detail more effortlessly. And you get the point. It's smooth, but it's not the smoothest ever. And what this does is this results in a presentation that's actually fairly easy to listen to. In fact, I've come to find that how you have them positioned really has an impact over what you're going to experience. For example, if you have the speakers towed directly out into the room with actually no tilt whatsoever, then you're going to experience something that's actually fairly smooth and, dare I even say, natural sounding. It's very, very good. Now, if you want something that's just a little bit more aggressive, then all you have to do is point the speakers directly at your listening position, and that's when things are going to get more lively. So the top end overall is pretty cool, and I would say is nothing spectacular, but in a way that's what makes it so good, is the fact that it's just easy to listen to. Now, the mid-range is going to be the star of the show, because as I said earlier, it really isn't thin, nor is it really warm sounding, and I like that because a lot of companies use these kind of tricks to create illusions. Thinness usually creates the illusion of depth, and then warmth, of course, creates the illusion of fullness, which is what a lot of manufacturers do with monitor designs. And the mid-range here is actually pretty damned natural. In fact, the best compliment that I could give it is I remember putting these speakers on my desktop where I had the Harbeth P3 ESRs, and I remember thinking, wow, these are the first speakers I've had in my desktop rig since the P3s that made me say, well, this is pretty natural sounding mid-range. And that's about as good of a compliment as I can give anything under $2,000. And then we have the bass. And the bass is going to be also dependent on a couple variables. Number one, it depends on what you connect the speakers to. Obviously, if you have a muscular amplifier that can really control bass, then you're going to get actually pretty tight and clean bass out of these. And also, you're going to want to pay attention to the type of stands you use. Thin stands or something that's not well dampened is going to result in bass that's definitely going to be on the warm side of neutral, if not even just a little bit slow. But if you take these speakers from the wall and you give them good current and a good set of stands, then the bass is actually going to be, it's not going to be the tightest in the world, but it's going to be tight enough. But most importantly, it's going to sound very full. And it's going to sound like a pair of monitors that are actually confident. Something that you don't have to worry about whether or not it's going to have enough low end to make the music sound enjoyable. Now, power handling is going to be absolutely fantastic on these speakers, but it's not at the expense of low volume fidelity. I listen predominantly at low volumes, and these speakers sound great at low volumes, even in the near field. In fact, my first experience with the S300s was hooking them up to my computer rig, and I thought it was going to be a disaster. And while I did have to plug the ports to get tight bass, I honestly loved it. The dispersion off these speakers, as far as imaging is concerned, is absolutely fantastic. And as you would expect with any two-way monitor, they definitely do a great job of laying down a huge soundstage, but they also do something that I've really only heard from a few other companies, most notably Totem Acoustic, which is they have this way of throwing down this huge soundstage that's a little bit forward, but at the same time, there's a lot of depth to the sound. You can actually experience a lot of the different layers in the recording through the S300s. And the better equipment that you connect to them, the more of that experience that you get. So overall, I mean, it's a fantastic listening experience. In fact, what I like so much about them is the fact that they're fairly easy to set up. I mean, yeah, if you want to get the best bass out of them, you do need to pay attention to amplifier and the stands and the distance from the wall. But overall, they're very easy to work with. And I like the fact that they sound really good with just about any type of music. In fact, I remember I had a friend over here and I had these set up, and I said, hey, let's listen to them. So I set them up on stands, didn't even try to calibrate them. I mean, literally just, boop, okay, let's put them there. My friend immediately reached for Disturbed, ABBA, and Richard Marx. Like, the worst recordings that I almost have in my entire collection is exactly what they went for. I thought it was going to be just horrible, and instead, it was actually pretty good. But when we reached for better recordings like Patricia Barber's Cafe Blue and so on and so forth, actually, you know what? They sounded like a proper set of hi-fi loudspeakers. And this is voicing that I think a lot of people are going to get into. Something that sounds good with real-world music, but can still sound enthralling with really good recording. So overall, yeah, the S300 Mark IIs. I can see why so many people love them, but they're not perfect. So let's talk about those imperfections now. All right, so as most of you guys know, compromise is a part of life, especially when you're building something to a particular price point. And in the case of the S300s, I do have a few complaints, and the first one is going to be about the packaging. Guys, when I pulled these out of their shipping cartons, I couldn't help but laugh because the packaging material definitely wasn't great, and it indicated that Bacard Audio is still a pretty young company. Now, I've been told that the Mark III version of this speaker has just launched. It features better binding posts, a few other upgrades, but most importantly, it's supposed to have proper packaging materials inside. Now, I haven't seen this, so I'm just gonna have to take them for the word on it. Now, moving on, when it comes to performance, I need to touch on dynamics. Now, this isn't a dynamically restrained speaker by any means, especially for the money, but it's clear that this design is meant to move a lot of air. It's meant to produce a lot of bass and, of course, to have great power handling. But when it comes to dynamics, which I define as the ability to move a lot of air and then stop on a dime, it's clear that there are other options out there that are going to be a little better at this. Again, it's not dynamically restrained so much as its forte is going to be more in moving a lot of air and producing quite a bit of bass. And then lastly, when it comes to the voicing, it is on the warm side of neutral, which means if you're somebody who's used to that lively type of sound, something with bumped up treble, then these speakers may come across as a little bit flat to you, or at least it may until you point them directly at your ears. Something worth noting. But anyways, otherwise, they're pretty good speakers, and that leads me to my final thoughts. All right, so let's go full circle here. In the beginning of the video, I told you guys about when I almost turned down the opportunity to review these speakers. And I did it because I had a moment of hubris. I thought, man, I've been down this path 1,000 times before. I don't need to hear another two-way monitor. You know what? Forget about it. But thankfully, I ended up following the advice that I've given you guys, which is to never let your ego get in the way of a good opportunity and to never think that you know it all. So I took these in and I'm glad I did, because they've ended up being a very pleasant surprise. Because the S300s, I get why so many people love these speakers now. I mean, they really are something like a jack of all trades. They sound great with a huge variety of music. They sound great on a wide variety of gear. And while they do require some things in order to sound their best, like quality stands, a little bit of distance from a wall, and of course a good strong amplifier, overall, this is a very easy speaker to recommend for somebody who wants something that will bring them a little less hi-fi anxiety and something that will engage them more with the music that they have. So as long as you can get past the plain looks and the relatively obscure brand name, I would say that this is something that's definitely worth checking out. Anyways, guys, that's just my take on the Bocart S300 Mark IIs. As always, thanks for watching, and until next time, peace. Bonus track, or wait, is that more like bonus video? I don't know. I just want to do something special for those of you who've hung around this long, and I thought it would be cool to do a quick little comparison between the Bocart S300 Mark IIs and the Totem Acoustic Skies, speakers that have a very different way of reproducing sound. Because on one hand, we have the Bocart audio speakers. These are all about having a neutral mid-range, a top end that's not really rolled off, nor is it going to be purposely tilted up. We have bass that's all about being big and powerful, and then we have the little Totem Acoustic Skies, which as you can tell are quite a bit smaller than the Bocarts. And these speakers are all about having a lively top end, a somewhat thin sounding mid-range, and of course very quick and agile bass. And the big question is, how do they stack up? What speaker would I prefer if I had to just live with one? Well, interestingly enough, I would say if you have nothing but excellent recordings in your collection, if you have a little bit of patience and real high quality stands, the Totem Acoustic Skies, I do think, sound just a little, just a smidgen more natural, especially in tone, than the Bocarts. But that's only if you have really good recordings and you know how to set these up properly. Because even though the Totem Sky was meant to be the easy Totem to work with, it's still a Totem. You still have to work a little bit to really get great sound out of them and to get fullness in the mid-range, while at the same time getting top end that's lively but not ear-piercing. Whereas the Bocarts are much easier to work with. I feel like I can just plop them down anywhere, throw music their way, and I'm going to get a more pleasing presentation. And the fact that the mid-range is so neutral really does help in this experience, because I don't have to worry about the mid-range ever really sounding unnatural, which is probably the most crucial part of the presentation. Now, which one would I live with, though? My God, that's tough. You guys know how much I like my Totems and the Totem sound. But if I had to pick a set of speakers to live with between the two, I'd have to go with the Bacarts, actually, just because I have such a wide variety of music. And at the end of the day, as much as I am a tone whore, and I really am a tone whore, I like the fact that these speakers sound fuller and I just don't have to stress as much about positioning as I do with the Totems. It's really, really close, and who knows, maybe I'll wake up tomorrow and land at a different conclusion, but for now, I have to give it to these guys. So anyways, that's my little bonus video for you. And now for real this time, peace.